So why everyone should install the brand new OpenCore Legacy Patcher 064 that was just released yesterday, I tell you in this video. So in the last few days, there were a lot of new versions released of the OpenCore Legacy Patcher, of OpenCore itself, due to the new macOS 13.3 and 13.3.1. The new OpenCore Legacy Patcher 064 that was just released yesterday brings a hotfix to version 063, and 063 was handling rendering issues with macOS 13.3 and with Safari 16.4. But a lot of you wrote in my comments, and that is one thing that I ask you to do. Please don't write me an email or anything, because then our conversation wouldn't be noticed by anyone else. If you have a problem, if you have a question, or if you have insights and something did work, just write a comment so everyone can read that comment here on my channel. And if you haven't yet, I would recommend you subscribe to the channel and click the bell for notification so you don't miss any news. And so we can spread the word to everyone here on the channel and to help each other. But the reason why I want you all to install 064 is, at first, it's a hotfix for Intel Ivy Bridge Max with Safari rendering. A lot of you wrote in the comment that they had issues running YouTube or Netflix or whatever on Safari, that it crashes or that some third-party apps crashes. 064 brings a hotfix to the type of rendering they implemented in 063, especially for Safari. And if you want to find out, that's Intel i3, i5 or i7 with a 3000 number afterwards. So that's Ivy Bridge. If you have a 4000 number, it's Haswell and so on. If you have a 2012 Mac and you have problems, and there are some other comments that I read that maybe on a old MacBook the keyboard lighting didn't work after installing 063. That is also fixed with 064, hopefully, especially for that model. So install this new version. But the second reason, and that is in my opinion the bigger reason, the developers now have a logging system, a reporting system, a statistics analytics system implemented in the backend. So that means if you are using 064 on your old Mac and you have problems, you have crashes, or if everything works, the developers get a very quite anonymous report of your Mac. So they can see, okay, what kind of Mac is running, what kind of macOS is running, and in which region of the world you are. And that's very broad. It's like US, Canada, Europe, and the language you set. So it's not like pinpointing your position with your IP or anything. So in my opinion, that is very valuable data that we all should provide the developers to enable them to improve the OpenCore Legacy Patcher, and OpenCore, they all work together to improve it more and more, and to fight the struggles we still see, especially with macOS Ventura on old Macs. As long as Apple has macOSs that still support Intel Macs and not switch completely to M1, M2 and so on to their own Apple Silicon, as long as they release new macOSs for Intel Macs, we should try to enable those unsupported Macs to install these macOSs. There was one more question, how to support me or to support my channel. If you view my videos and if you spread the word and share the links and all in the community, that's quite enough. If you really want to do something more, then you can maybe choose a super thanks, that you can add an amount of money. But again, I'm so happy that my channel is still growing and so many of you give me comments, give me insights, and give me feedback about macOS on old unsupported Macs. And if you didn't know yet, I'm moving to the US next week. I'm a German Air Force flight instructor in real life, and I have an assignment in the USA in Arizona. So if you're interested, my vlog channel, Jesse's Flying USA, will give you twice a week an update how we are doing, but as it's for our German audiences, because we moved from Germany to the US, it's in German, but there are English subtitles. Thank you so much for watching and stay tuned. You see here, my Mac Pro 2013 is working right now because I'm working on my next video. Is it worth running Ventura on a Mac Pro 2013? If you haven't seen it, my old video, is it worth running Ventura on a Mac Pro cheese grater, is already online. And I can tease a little bit about the Mac Pro 2013. It's running quite well. Ventura, I still have to test 064, but I'm struggling with eGPUs. So stay tuned for the next video. Thank you for watching. See you soon. Bye bye.